Through them, you led us to the true faith. Oh. St. Paul to the Hebrews.
Wisdom.
Brethren, your leaders who spoke the word of God to you, consider how their lives ended and imitate their faith. Jesus Christ is the same today, yesterday, and forever. Do not be carried away by all kinds of strange teaching. It is good to have our hearts strengthened by the grace of God, and not by foods which are useless to those who take them as a standard for living. We have an altar from which those who serve the tabernacle have no right to eat. The bodies of the animals whose blood is brought into the sanctuary by the high priest as a sin offering are burned outside the camp. Therefore, Jesus died outside the gate to sanctify the people by his own blood. Let us go to him outside the camp, bearing the insult which he bore. For here we have no lasting city. We are seeking one which is to come. Through him let us continually offer God a sacrifice of praise, that is the fruit of lips which acknowledge his name. Do not neglect good deeds and generosity. God is pleased by sacrifices of that
because it had no moisture. And other seed fell among thorns, and the thorns sprang up with it and choked it. And the other seed fell upon good ground and sprang up and yielded fruit 100-fold. And as he said these things, he cried out, "He who has ears to hear, let him hear." But his disciples then began to ask him what this parable meant. He said to them, "To you it is given to know the mystery of the kingdom of God, but to the rest in parables, that seeing they may not see, and hearing they may not understand. Now the parable is this: the seed is the word of God, and those by the wayside are those who have heard, then the devil comes and takes away the word from their heart, that they may not believe and be saved. Now those upon the rock are they who, when they have heard, receive the word with joy, and these have no root, but believe for a while, and in time of temptation fall away. And that which fell among the thorns, these are they who have heard, and as they go their way, are choked by the cares and riches and pleasures of life, and their fruit does not ripen. But that upon good ground, these are they who, with a right and good heart, having heard the word, hold it fast, and bear fruit in patience. When he said this, he cried out, "He who has ears, let him hear."
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you. He's full of pity.
How would it be in Arabic? Greek.
Greek? Loxa si Christe.
Okay, God bless you, it's so wonderful. I'm looking for somebody who knows Hungarian too. But again, I welcome everybody who's experiencing the encounter this week to be celebrating the Divine Liturgy with us today and all of our parish family of St. Mary's. But as usual, a pastor does indeed have to make some announcements of stuff that's happening in the parish right now, so a little bit of business before I begin my homily. As you can see, or maybe as you notice when you're walking in, the Knights of Columbus are making a collection today. I ask that everybody be generous, and even our visitors today, if they didn't have a chance to put something in the can, maybe you might wish to do that. Also, all of our parishioners, some of our vendors are still open after today's liturgy. If you go into the gym side of the parish center, you'll be able to see some wonderful, might be able to do some of your Christmas shopping. You'll see some wonderful icons and books, and so I encourage you to take a look at them. And if you haven't had, if you're not attending the encounter and you want to know what was going on, there are also videos and tapes, videos and CDs of the conferences. So wander over there. But unfortunately, with everything going on today, no coffee and donuts. But I know. So no coffee and donuts. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. What a blessing. As we come together today, this encounter of the Eastern Catholic Churches provides us to the opportunity to reflect upon what God has done through the Eastern Catholic Churches of the United States for probably close to 150 years. It's a time for us to reflect upon our experiences of God being, as it says in Psalm 46, our refuge and our strength in times of trouble. Thus, there is no cause to fear, even though indeed change is all around us. From generation to generation, the Eastern Catholic Churches in the United States have taken root and have spread their branches. However, the message of Christ needs to be re-sown and watered. Isn't that wonderful, the gospel that we have today? The seeds being thrown out. How are they received? How are they cultivated? But we as Christians need to re-sow those seeds. This is the new evangelization that we've been hearing so much about. In fact, as we come today to celebrate this liturgy, so many of the bishops throughout the world are in Rome meeting and talking and developing plans for the new evangelization. I ask you to think about what we read in Psalm 145. One generation to the next and proclaims your mighty works. One generation to another, how many generations have there been have come through the doors of our Eastern Catholic parishes since our ancestors have come from the old countries? Each generation contributes a chapter, and the chapters make up a book of God's praise, a book of the mighty works of our Almighty God. Today, as we come together, those of us of my parish family and those of us who are experiencing the encounter this weekend, we come together to write another chapter in the book of God's praise, committing ourselves and one another, committing our generation to spread the good news, to spread the news from one generation to the next. And that's our responsibility today as we come together to take what you've been given and to pass it to the next generation. The Christian life is not a marathon. The Christian life is really sort of like a relay race, right? You know, we watch the Olympics and we've seen relay races, right, going. And we look at a relay race, and what do we look at when we look at the Christian life as a relay race? Is we pass on what it is that we know, what it is that we believe, from one generation to the next, right? Now, I'm going to embarrass one of my parishioners, because she is of the oldest generation who's here today. That's you, Mary, right? Okay? Now, what I want you to do, Mary, is to take this and to start passing it on, because the witness of our older people, our older generations, is why we have the Eastern churches throughout the United States today. Passing on the faith. And what I have here is I have the creed, our faith. So I do believe, unless there's somebody older than you here today, Mary. Mary's 94, right? I'm sorry on that. She didn't want me to advertise. But we know she's really a young 94. So Mary, I asked if you take this, and let's see, who's one of our younger people here today? Let's see. Well, how about, I think Zach is probably our youngest one here today. Zach, can you come up here for a second? No? The faith that Mary professes and we believe is the same faith that was professed by Zach's godparents 3 years ago when I baptized him. And so now, Zach, I need for you to find that little baby in the crib of the car over there. What do you call those things? That's what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to take on the faith, and we're supposed to pass it on. And so what does our Lord tell us to do but to what?
Pass it on.
Pass it on. Pass it on. Pass on the faith. This wonderful faith that we profess, But as we've been talking about during the time of the encounter, our faith is not porohi, our faith is not hummus, our faith is not falafel, our faith is not that, but our faith is the creed, what it is that we profess. So our second oldest person here today, Mary, pass it on. Pass it on, pass it on. And some of our younger people here today who are singing, leading us in song, we pass it on. Pass on the faith. Pass it on. Pass on what it is that we believe. But one of the things that I want you to do as we're passing it on in church is I want you not only to pass it on in church, but where else are we going to pass it on, sister? Where else are we going to pass it on? Everywhere. Exactly. Pass it on. Pass it on. Because one of the things that I think is so wonderful about Eastern Catholic Christians is that we are not selfish people. We have so many wonderful gifts in our church, in our faith, in our worship, in our celebration, in our love of Almighty God. So what do we do, Bonnie? Pass. We pass it on. And let's be honest. If we as Eastern Catholic Christians 150 years ago we're truly living the gospel message of passing it on day after day, week after week. Because we have the greatest gift, I believe, in our worship and in our praise of Almighty God, we've been a little weak in doing that. So I hope today, as we continue the celebration, and I thank Bishop Nicholas for celebrating this liturgy with us, that we realize that we are indeed the relay race. Somebody hands the baton to you, you run as fast as you can to share that good news and hand it off to somebody else. You've been given the mighty baton, the heritage of God's faithfulness. Now, as we leave this gathering today, let's run as fast as we can to share this good news with someone else. Let's do it. Let's do it. And my prayer as we do it is that when we get to heaven, the past will say to us, you kept the faith. And the future will say to us, you passed it on to us. Eastern Catholic churches in the United States have been praising and proclaiming God's mighty works for 150 years. Your faith and your fidelity has been a blessing to all of our communities and to each other. Our Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI, has proclaimed right now that we are in the middle of a year of faith, which began on October the 11th and runs through November of 2013. The Holy Father has said that he hopes this occasion will provide renewed energy to the mission of the whole church to lead men and women out of the desert, as they often are in, and towards a place of life. Friendship with Christ, who gives us fullness of life. The Pope has also said that he hopes that the year of faith will be a moment of grace and commitment to an even fuller conversion to God, to reinforce our faith in him, and to proclaim him with joy to the people of our time. So please, I implore you, I beg, that you use this opportunity of the year of faith to begin a new evangelization to those around you, and a new evangelization in your own hearts, and that you use the fruits of this encounter, that you use the fruits of this divine liturgy to commit yourselves and one another and your whole life to Christ our God. May God bless you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
at all times, now and always, and forever and ever.
May he grant them rest in the bosom of Abraham and number them among the saints. May the Lord God remember us all in his kingdom at all times, now and always, and forever and ever.
Of one essence of the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us
us be attentive to offer the holy oblation in peace.
We give thanks to you, Lord.
speak to me confidence in you, and not for judgment or condemnation, and get me off of this street to worship. To those resting in the faith, forefathers and fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, confessors, ascetics, for every holy soul on the course of faith, especially, we are all holy, spotless, the most highly blessed and glorious Lady, the Mother of God and the ever-Virgin Mary.
Receive
senses, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For good and profitable to our souls and for peace in the world, let us ask the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
For our life may be spent in peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord. Judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant this, O Lord.
For great community of faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
Pray.
not, O Son of God, as a participant in your mystical supper, for I will not betray your mystery to your enemies, nor give you a kiss like Judas, but like a thief I confess you. Remember me, Lord, in your kingdom. May the reception of your holy mysteries lead for me not to judgment or condemnation, but to the healing of my soul and body.
Approach with the fear of God, with faith and with love.
Amen. Amen. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. The Lord is God, and he has appeared to us.
Jesus Christ. The servant of God receives the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. The servant of God receives the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Listen.
is our God at all times, now and always, and forever and ever.
Love for mankind at all times, now and always, and forever and ever.